In this video, we're going to be going over the outer glow feature available in STYLISM by Astute Graphics. Here I've got some artwork drawn out, and I just want to come over here to the STYLISM panel and show you this section here. These are all the different effects you could apply to your selected artwork. The one I want to focus on for this video is this outer glow. When I click on it, it automatically adds this outer glow live effect to my selected artwork. And if you see here on the Tools panel, it activated the STYLISM tool. Over here in the Appearance panel, it added the outer glow to the bottom of the stack. This is the outer glow that ships native with Adobe Illustrator. I'll go ahead and hide this guy. Next, let's see how we can make some changes to this glow. When I hover over this annotation, it's showing me that this blur is set to 5 pixels. I'll click and drag and bring it towards the center, and you see I've reduced the blur to 0 pixels. So when I release, the blur is completely gone. I'll click and drag and bring it over to the edge, and you see the blur maxes out at 144 pixels. When I release, this outer glow is completely blurred out. I can bring it back more towards the center, and that looks a lot better. When I hover over this guy, this is going to take care of the opacity. It's set at 75% now, but when I click and drag towards the edge, you see I could bring it up to 100%. And if I click and drag and bring it towards the center, you see I've reduced the opacity down to 0%. Now I just click and drag and gradually introduce more of this glow until I get the look I'm going for. Now, sometimes these sliders might move back and forth too fast if you want to make some really small changes. If that's the case, just hold down the Command key and you'll see the slider slows down a bit. I'll go ahead and release and I'll show you again on this guy. All I have to do is click, drag, and then introduce the Command key on a Mac or Control key on a PC. And you see it'll slow down these sliders for you. I'll release, and there you go. Now if you want to enter a specific value, just double click on this handle, and you come in here and enter a blur value of 10, or whatever you need for that job. And you see in the annotation, it's showing me that the blur value has changed to 10 pixels. I'll come over to this one, double click on it, and I want this to be exactly 50%. I'll click OK, and you see it's been added here on my annotation. I could also change the color of the blur by clicking on this thumbnail. It brings up my color picker, and I can make whatever changes I want in this panel. It's updated my color, and now I have the option of going to this drop-down menu and choosing any of these blending modes you're used to working with. I'm going to choose Overlay, and you see it updated the change right along here. Now let's head back over here to the STYLISM panel. I want to show you this resolution section. In here, you could actually manually enter in a specific resolution. So I'm going to drop it down to 20 ppi, and you see it makes a difference right in here on this effect. It's actually made it a little bit more choppy. Bring the opacity up a bit so you could see the effect. We also have these presets here. I could bring the resolution up to 300 ppi, or I could drop it back down to 72 ppi, which is great for making edits or exporting for the web. You can make changes to these presets, but we'll cover that in a different video. Down here at the bottom, you see you have this curves graph. Well, I'm going to make a couple changes to this, and you'll see the changes take place here on my artboard. Now, you won't see this graph unless you have Phantasm installed on your machine. Phantasm is going to allow you to have full control over this edge here. So you see I've been able to create this subtle blend. Well, you could also come in here and start adding more of these anchor points and getting a very dramatic effect. There you go, and then I'll just drop this guy down to the bottom and see what happens. There you go, I was able to create this crazy looking ring effect here. If I get a graph that I like, I could save it off, or I could input previous graphs that I've used in the past. For more information on that, be sure to check out the Phantasm Stylism videos that are coming up, and also we'll have some videos specifically covering the resolution features. And there you have it, folks. That's the outer glow feature available in STYLISM by Astute Graphics.